Well, somebody had a great idea to send D Troop out to the field without our 106 Jeeps. We had our 106s, but no Jeeps. As you can see down in the left-hand corner of the picture, there's a 106 sitting on the ground. It weighs well over 1,000 pounds. The rounds are 97 pounds apiece. And here we were out in the middle of nowhere humping this stuff. They realized after one night it was a bad move, so they put us on deuce and a halves, and they shipped us off to Baswa. As you can see in the background, it's raining. There's some rain coming down here. That's why I kind of took this particular photo. So we got to Baswa. It was time to unload the trucks and start getting ourselves and our gear together. Baswa had an interesting sign there when we got there. It said, "What God abandoned." So we got there. We had to unload and start humping the 106s. We had to carry it up on top of this one hill. As you can see, it's sitting up there. And then, of course, carry all the rounds up there. We had four 106s with us that particular day. One of them we put right up on top of this bunker. We got up on top of the hill. You can see the 106, the 105 pit, the 4 deuce mortar, a 106 way up to the right. The other two 106s were on the other side of the knoll, which was Baswa. There's a clear shot of the 4 deuce mortar pit down there. There's Pappy and Crandall sitting up on top of a big rock. Baswa was real close to the Cambodian border, if I recall. Here's Crandall coming up the side. The Green Berets really only had one path right up to the top of this place. And up on top, they had, I think this was a 90 recoilless rifle. Could be a 60 or something, but it was recoilless. So when we had our 106s, they were quite happy to have those all around that place. We were there maybe 2 days when we finally got hit late at night by a small little ground attack. Can you imagine 50 caliber machine guns, 60 caliber machine guns, 106s, 105s, or not 105s, but that 90 recoilless. But the Gooks made a direct hit right into that 105 pit and also the 4 deuce mortar pit. And we were just on the other side. You can see right on the other side of that little building is where that bunker was, and that thing came in and slammed. This is Mike Gibbons. He was at the Black Hawk reunion. Some guys might know him or recognize him. Mike went at the top of the hill there. But yeah, it came in and hit right in that 105 pit. They also hit the mortar pit and also a couple buildings that were housing a bunch of the Cambodians there. And a number of Cambodians lost their lives in that building that night. I can't remember or recall how many, but they took a direct hit right up on top of those as well. And on the area, this was also pretty neat to see. This is a little boy, was an albino. He had a twin brother there. His mother was albino. And there were his little Cambodian friends and little Cambos. You can see way up in the background of them, that's where the 106 was at. These are some photos I took at the inauguration of the statue in D.C. I thought I just throw these photos in there and share them. There's a National Geographic magazine, and some of my photos were like real close. Right up in the left-hand corner is where they were starting to play taps, and it's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It was pretty bizarre out there. And I also left my Detroit Tigers baseball cap there, which ended up going into some of the archives, like everybody else's stuff. So there's your Battle of Baswa. Hope you enjoyed. Hope this turns out okay.